Boy howdy everyone, this is Shaney Merztier here with another 5-Minute Fix. So what we're going to do today is get a major step out of the way for getting your avatar ready or updated for Avatars 3.0. In this case, it's getting hand gestures for your facial animations to work. What that means is if you make, say, a peace sign, you can make an animation happen on your face or elsewhere, which is essentially, you know, a gesture. The problem is it's kind of voodoo magic to do in 3.0, especially if you're not good at Unity like myself, but we now have cool tools made up by the community to do this very, very easily. Without the need to manually set up animators or anything, just going through your blend shapes in a nice user interface, blending them how you want, and wrap it up by choosing which gesture causes the animation. It's that easy. Like, it is. Let's get started. You'll need the following things, like if you're just starting with 3.0, a new Unity project. Then you need to bring in your model, your shaders, the model's materials if you've extracted them, Avatar's 3.0 SDK from VRChat, whatever tools you use otherwise, like Dynamic Bones or Pumpkin's Avatar tools, and finally, Combo Gesture by Hi. See the description for it. Though this tool can also make puppets and blend trees and stuff like that, that's way beyond this tutorial. Don't worry about it. We're moving on. Just focus. We're doing the thing. So I've done all that and slapped some materials on so you can see my face because that's all that's really necessary for this demonstration. And I guess a necessary note is in order. Like, your character has to have blend shapes, else this ain't gonna work. Is it a necessary note? I don't know. So the absolute first thing you have to do is bring your avatar into the scene and add the avatar descriptor from VRChat. Without it, the tools won't know what your avatar is in the scene, and it just can't find it. Once you set that up, go to the Project Folder pane and go to Assets, High, Combo Gesture, and select the Combo Gesture Expressions prefab, and go ahead and drag that into your hierarchy. From there, right-click on Combo Gesture Expressions, and click Unpack Prefab completely, because it likes to be in pieces for reasons that we can't get into in this specific tutorial. From there, click the foldy triangle next to Combo Gesture Expressions, click on Default, and in the inspector, you'll see an Open Editor button. Hit it, and you'll see a window pop up called CGE/Default. Mash that fat button that says Automatically Set Up Preview and you'll get moved into the Set Face Expressions tab. Now this window is the big cheese, though it looks complicated at the moment. This is where all your gestures are shown, from what happens when you clench your fist, or open your palms, or do nothing, etc, etc. So go ahead and click Create on one of them, like this open one. Suddenly the EE Animation Editor will pop up. This is the box that gathers all the blend shapes you want to use and customize them into a completed quote unquote look. And I'll explain what I mean right now. So when you click plus, you'll get yet another window. And let me organize all these things here real quick. You'll get this new window called EE Property Explorer. And don't worry about the name, just click the super long button that says Generate Previews. And this is the point where I fell in love with this tool, right? Now that it's generated, you'll see every single blend shape you have, all fully engaged to 100%, so you can easily see the ones you want to blend together into a look. It even highlights what changes are in each blend shape, so it's quick and easy to figure out. You can easily see the blinks, the winks, the smiles, the furrowed brows, whatever. But what we want, or at least what I want, is when I open my hands, I want to be smiling. And of course, when I'm smiling, I want to look happy, so I'm going to click the plus icon under Blink Happy, and you can see it's selected now because we can remove it. Now, if we go back to the animation editor, check this out, we'll see that we have that blend shape now in our animation. Now I can set how much this blends with the default look. So I'll set this to 100, and I also want to also not look so angry. So if I go back to the Property Explorer, we'll scroll down looking for eyebrows. Oh, here's one, sadness. Back to the editor, and let's tweak that a little bit so I don't look so constipated. So I don't think it looks perfect yet, so let's find more eyebrows and blend them all together. And that'll do for now. This is just showing that it works. Now let's change that name. Animation, closed eyes, and click rename. And if you've been looking at your projects folder, you'll notice that the animation file there has been renamed. Maybe we should make a folder for that. So let's right click down there and do create folder, and we'll call it animations. Let's move that baby right into there and open that folder so the next one saves there too. So now we have one animation, let's make one more. Let's do victory because victory is always my wink. So back into the animation editor and you'll see we're in a default stance again. Hit up Property Explorer and we'll look for a wink and we'll find a happy face and then I guess we'll find a smile too. And then back to the animation editor and whoa, that's a bit much. Let's dial this in to something that looks good. Great, let's name it animation wink. Rename. Cool, so now we have two animations that have just been created in no time at all and plugged into our matrix of stuff. Feel free to fill out this matrix to your heart's content. It even has options for what happens when two things happen at the same time, like clenching your fist while doing rock and roll, for example. You have two hands, remember. Maybe you don't want it to do anything different, so you may want to auto-set that, or maybe you want to blend two together with combine. You have a pile of options. For example, with left fist and right open, when I have both of those going at the same time, I want open to take precedent, so I'll make sure that looks right by hitting up auto set. This helps preventing accidental gestures too. So after you're done filling in all combos, or maybe you're just getting overwhelmed with all these boxes, you can select the singles tab on the top, which will show not just when one of your hands are doing something, but when both are doing the same thing. You can create a special animation for, say, two peace signs, or auto set it so you're sure it's going to work the way you want it to. Oh yeah, and make sure you set a no gesture, aka the default state. And don't worry about how it looks here, it's just a bug with my avatar or something. The little draggy thing here is transition time between gestures. You can make it longer so it makes your face take longer to transition from state to state, but most people, myself included, don't need it any faster or slower. In fact, this is as fast as you can get without it getting really goofy, so just leave it. And then we can go over to prevent eyes blinking, and this is specifically to stop the eyes from blinking in certain gestures. Like if your eyes are already closed, for example, or your avatar is ever seeing and should never blink. So select all the gestures where both your eyes are fully closed. Note that this is not for winking, this is for closed eyes only. Make lip sync movements subtle is to keep your mouth from overexploding when your mouth is already big from a gesture. So select expressions with a wide open mouth here, but mind the warning though, as it apparently may be broken and has been left in for a potential fix from VRChat. Maybe it works now? Who knows? Skip it if you're worried. Additional editors is beyond this tutorial because we're not making complex blend trees or paper dolls or emotion states like a series of sad or angry gestures only. So don't worry about this for now. If you want to learn about it, links in the description. So once you're happy with your setup, we're going to click on Combo Gesture Expressions back in the hierarchy, and what we're looking for is the avatar descriptor, so go ahead and select your avatar in the hierarchy and just slap it in there. Further, we're going to need an FX animator controller. Now, you may have one already, but there's nothing wrong with creating a new one by right-clicking on your project folder, Create Animator Controller. We'll throw it back into my animations folder and name it SDK3_controller while we're at it. And if we open the animator, what we'll see is that it's empty, and that's perfect because Combo Gesture Expressions is going to write everything it needs in there. So we'll just open Combo Gesture Expressions again and just drag that new animator controller into the FX animator controller box, and in our example, we'll be using VRChat recommendations for it. And since we don't need support for ears or wings or whatever to animate with these gestures, aka it's all in the face, we won't check off the gesture playable layers box. Slap that synchronize animator effects layers button, and we hit up our SDK3 controller again. And by the way, if you don't have the animator window, it's under window animation animator. We'll see the base layer, which looks like our original newly minted one, but now we have all this other stuff, and this is our gestures all compiled into the system with us never having to touch it, which is amazing. Now that that's all done, you're pretty much all set to go. All you gotta do is make sure that your animator controller is none and configure it like you would a regular SDK3 avatar. You know, set it up as humanoid, all that rot. The only thing you need to do in particular is right here with the FX system under base. Make sure you drag in the SDK3 controller that we created earlier. This will attach all those gestures to your avatar. And that's literally about it. Go on into VRC SDK, upload, and let's find out how it came out. And just like that. Ta-da! Hey. It all works. But as you can see, I didn't set up the times two hands thing. Oh well, it happens. Alright everybody, and that's it. That's how you make gestures in SDK3 quick and easy. This has been Shaney Mirz here. Thank you so much for watching. Please like and subscribe. We'll see you next time, alright? Peace out.